Stay up out the way, don't get your shit splat. Stop, let this shit slide and get your lick back. And get your lick back. Get your lick back. If a nigga owe you something, ain't no chit chat. Better stay up out the way, don't get your shit splat. Stop, let this shit slide and get your lick back. And get your lick back. I feel like I'm JX.
J-Way.
I'm a perfectionist, Adderall got me restless.
I'm gone.
Run with a wild crew, they get reckless. Young boy, come up off that neck.
Give me
to the trends. CLE be the best.
Welcome to Bleachers and Speakers. I'm your host, Joe, and I got my boy B. Foster with me. And we are back doing another featured player of the week. It's been a long time, Foss. But before we get into that, I want to urge everyone to subscribe to Bleachers and Speakers on YouTube. There you can catch more of these features, Player of the Week, along with our other episodes. And you can check us out on any of the podcast aggregators. Just type in Bleachers Speakers, FFSN, follow us. Make sure you got a notification bell on. So when we drop content, you'll get an alert and download those episodes. Foster, who are we talking about this week?
All right. This week we are talking about Trevor Nowaske. Originally from Canton, Michigan, but he attended Saginaw Valley State University. He is an outside linebacker, and this is a big boy. He's 6'3", 237 pounds. He ran a 4.5 40, which ain't too shabby for a guy that size. He had 25 bench reps, and he had a 34.5-inch vertical. As far as his college career is concerned, in 2019, he played in 11 games and had 16 tackles. And his monster breakout year was in 2021, where he played in 11 games, had 84 tackles, 4.5 sacks, 9.5 tackles for loss, 1 forced fumble, 1 interception, and 3 pass breakups. And that year, he was all GLIAC honorable mention. And this is a Division I school, Saginaw Valley State. As far as his attributes, he is a strong tackler. He has good tackling power and good form. And when you try to describe who he is as a player, it's versatile. He can play the Mike position as well as the Sam position. And he has good lateral movement, good fluid lateral movement. And he has the ability to pass rush as well. He already has 2 sacks already this year in limited opportunities. He's gotten more of an opportunity since Derek Barnes has been injured. But he also is adept in the zone coverage game as well. What's going to help him at the next level as he adjusts to the speed and athleticism is his IQ. He does a good job of diagnosing what's going on in the offense so he can make his next move. And he's credited Jalen Reeves Maven as somebody that has kind of taken him under his wing to kind of show him the ropes. Obviously, he's a veteran and has been around a long time. And as far as his career with the Lions, he was an undrafted free agent in 2023. He was up and down from the practice squad last year, and eventually midway through the year, he was signed by the Arizona Cardinals, because obviously when you're not signed to the team, you're left susceptible to being picked up by other teams. So he played with the Arizona Cardinals for the remainder of last year and played with them up until the end of training camp, of training camp this year in August. He was waived by the Arizona Cardinals, and the Lions were able to re-sign him to the practice. They were able to re-sign him to the Lions. It may have been the practice squad, but it may not have been. Obviously, he's playing with us right now. They kind of had a little bit about his experience as far as the draft is concerned. He pretty much knew he wasn't going to be drafted, but he figured that he'd have a few options to pick from as far as undrafted free agency. But the only team that gave him a shot was initially the Detroit Lions, which is where he played. Which is where he played as far as training camp is concerned. And he played in the preseason with the Lions. But now he is back with the Detroit Lions, and he's flourishing. He had a great game this past ball game. He had one of the highest PFF ratings. He had an 87.1 versus the Vikings. The linebacking core as a whole did a pretty good job. And like I said, he's got two sacks already this year. And overall, he has an 83.5 PFF rating. And he will continue to get opportunities while Derek Barnes is out. Derek Barnes will probably be out for the remainder of at least this calendar year, but likely the entire season. So, yeah, Trevor Nowaske will continue to get an opportunity to show that versatility in zone coverage. And he's pretty adept at pass rushing, which is something that the Lions will need from him as we try to shoulder the load left behind by Aiden Hutchinson. So that is the hometown guy, out of Canton. And I want to say Hutch is from what? Plymouth, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So he's from.
I thought he was from Dearborn.
He went to high school. He went to, I don't know what the school is in Dearborn, but he commuted from.
Okay.
Plymouth or Canton.
He's from Canton. He just played in Dearborn.
What's fair? Divine Child.
Divine Child.
Yeah. So they're actually both from the same area and probably the same age, right?
Yeah, something like that.
Around the same age.
Yeah, they're in the same ballpark.
I'm sure they've crossed paths. So that is Trevor Nowaske.
Yeah, and he got a sack to end the game. That was great effort. And when I thought something could go wrong, he ended the game there. So shout out to Trev. Make sure you subscribe to Bleachers and Speakers. Foster, you did another good job, man, on this feature player. We got to do some more of these.
We got some more in the tuck. You will certainly see some more coming up.
All right, subscribe to Bleachers and Speakers on YouTube.
Get your lick back. If an onion on you, something ain't no chit chat. Better stay up out the way. Don't get your shit splashed.